that's how I get that ooh.
And now back to your regularly scheduled program.
What's good to YouTube? How's everyone doing? Welcome to the channel, or welcome back to yet another live reaction video. If you're new here for the first time, my name is TMR, and since you clicked on this video, you might as well subscribe to the YouTube channel, leave your comments down below, and enjoy this reaction video. What's good to YouTube? What's good, TMR gang? Welcome back to the channel and welcome back to yet another live reaction video. I'm your girl, TMR. Thank y'all so much for stopping what you were doing and meet me over in this damn break room, y'all. Oh, boy. All right, y'all. Oh, Lord. Y'all see the title, baby. I just don't know what to say anymore. I mean, y'all probably like, TMR, girl, what the hell is you damn talking about? Well, y'all, Sky. But y'all thought I really had something to talk about. No, really, though, no, for real. I'm serious. I'm tired. Okay? I know, Miss TLD. I know, girl. Yana said, oh, Lord. Yana said, oh, Lord. PJ. Janae, girl, I'm saying. Baby, I was being nosy on the damn internet, and I fell across this video, and I said, now, wait a damn minute, Sky. I'm about sick of your damn ass. I am sick of you. Girl, I'm probably getting more sick of you than I am a Diddy damn ass. I thought I was sick of Diddy. But Sky, you are making me mad, ma'am. I want to know why you keep getting on this good internet. I want to know why you keep getting on this internet with this old horrible ass cleaning that you over here doing. Girl, hold on. Hold on. Hold on. Sky. Why do you keep, girl, what is wrong with you? Is something wrong with you? Something gotta be. Somebody called a therapist. Girl, what is going on with you? Why do you think it's cute to show your nasty ass house? Now, I remember a long time ago, I did a reaction to a clean with me. I can't remember who it was. And someone had responded in my comments and they was like, well, the whole purpose of a clean with me is to see the nasty and then the clean. And I'm like, I mean, I guess you can't clean a clean house. So that makes sense. But this over here, man, what a girl. Who, what? Janae. She said she's so damn trippy. She said her and those roaches will go viral by any means necessary. Girl, I'm just thinking to myself, ma'am, why? What is going on over there with you? I'm tired of getting hazmat suits with this chick I'm calling out today. Shella said, I ain't coming to work. TMR, damn you and the break room. Shella, don't go, sis. Hey, Uniquely. Hey, Nisha. Hey, Miss Jones. Hey, Sean. Girl, I'm just trying to figure out why, okay? Trisha said, it should never get that nasty, though. It shouldn't. Even when you moving, y'all know when you're moving, your house is chaotic because it's bags and boxes and totes. And baby, this ain't even moving. This airy day for her over there. And I'm just like, girl, what is going on? Now, I understand there's a lot of things going on in the world. Who just said that? Hey, Lynn. Hey, Newton. Go get it. What's good, y'all? I'm sorry I didn't speak, y'all. I'm just tired of her. Her, our new forever. K Solo said, yes, I did see there was an earthquake in New Jersey. I think it was 4.3 on the Richter scale. Child, I mean, that's Mother Nature, you know? It can happen anywhere, anytime. Miss Petty said, hey, one, just leaving work from home, showered, and off to the next job. I'll catch y'all in the replay. Miss Petty, you know, you working hard for that new house, huh, baby? I know that's right, girl. Get your damn coins, ma'am. Oh, Lord. I just, Nike, what's good? Hey, Bria. Hey, y'all. I found this. Hey, Majesty. Hey, Whitwheel. Selena, Suma, Nurse KP, LWJ Creations, Queen K. Hey, y'all. I just want to know why she keep doing this. And y'all want to know what I'm talking about. We getting ready to show you, okay? Hey, Miss Purple. I might need to come back. No, Miss Purple, stay right here, girl. You already done sat down. Yeah, I'm going to show y'all what I'm talking about. Hold on. Let me get her on the daggone screen. Where's she at? Here she go. Now, y'all, she got music, so I ain't going to play the music. I'm just going to play her. At this point, we don't even need no damn music. Hold on, y'all. Give me a moment, wait a minute. Let me take this thing off the screen because I want y'all to see what is going on here. I want y'all to see. How does this happen? What? Why is all them clothes on the floor? What is going on in here, ma'am? You got 6 kids. You don't think your kids deserve to live in a clean environment? Beds on the floor. What is all, what broom? Where is the dustpan? Child, F a broom. Where is the shovel? Because at this point, baby, we need a shovel. How does the room look? So you don't check your kids' rooms? But hell, her room look like this. What is all this trash on the floor? So don't nobody use a garbage can? All these holes in the wall? What? And you upload this for entertainment? Who's entertained? Look at this. I bet them kids' desk at school is a mess. Because if the house look like this, their bedrooms look like this, I bet they little desk and they locker. What? Now look at this. So you do got a vacuum cleaner. What is that big old spot on the floor? Girl, you need a carpet cleaner. Food on the floor. You got roaches, but you got the pizza boxes on the floor. Baby, y'all in here. But hold on. Hold on. Hold on. Hold on. We in here painting. You act like you moving out or moving in. You currently live here. She act like she remodeling. Oh, my goodness. Lord, ain't a man in sight to help. But he was over there for 4 months and couldn't even give you $39 for the water bill. Now you got to pay and he gone. He took his trash bags, threw it on the side of the house, and he didn't broke camp. And you in here painting you and the kiddos by yourselves. But he got to lay up in there for 4 months for free. Huh! Bubba! Child Sky. Girl, you got to do better than this, ma'am. Peach can't help you. She over there meeting JT at the club. And you in here painting and scrubbing walls. And Peach over there meeting JT from the City Girls with your money that you paid her for. Ain't that something? Child, look at this. Baby. Oh, so this another day. You change clothes? Oh, okay. Let me get over here to y'all comments. You staying in the car, Keisha? Hold on, let me get to y'all comments. Oh, so they clean to get the whole walls to the point. Yeah, sis. Lo says, painting over the dirt without washing the walls is wild and trifling, baby. It's insane. Okay? She said, new paint, new walls. It don't matter if they was dirty. She, new paint, new walls. Yes, that's paint on the dresser because she had the kiddos over there painting. Child. West Coast Suma said, Peach gonna have them bums stinking. JT gonna let everyone wear her shirt. Okay. I don't know, y'all. Let me get a few more minutes in over here. Okay. Look at that. She in here moving dresses and stuff like she a damn man. Like Jasmine with her bob. Me, I remember Jasmine with her Bob the Builder tool belt. Oh, Lord. And the funny thing is, it's not going to stay like this. Look at the dog. Poor dog. Okay, so now you got the kids to bed. So this was prior to her getting the kids to bed. Okay. Sis in here putting it together herself. I guess, sis, if you ain't got nobody to help you, I sure hope ain't no man smiling in your face and you over here putting a bed together by yourself. Child, please. I don't get it. And again, Sky has Section 8. She's low income. And the reality is everybody on Section 8 and low income don't live like that. And I just don't understand why these women like to get on the internet and embarrass themselves like this. Because I'm going to be honest with you, sis. This ain't helping anybody. And Sky knows she wrong. That's why she keep her comments off. This ain't helping anybody. Okay, let me speed past this because, child, we all know how the pieces to the bed. Okay, yeah, okay, so you got that going on. Okay, she's still putting up the bed. Girl, it took you forever to put that bed up. Oh, yeah, because it was a bunk bed. Okay, you still in here. Was this a whole nother day? Let's get over here. Okay. Okay, well, she looked like she finally finished it. Okay. Oh, you put this, okay, mattress on there. You got some mattress covers? Good, because the mattress probably looked like Chrissy's. Okay, well, at least the kids got a bed. Now, the trick is, Sky, make them kids clean up after themselves. Because let's be honest. You are the woman of the home, but you shouldn't have to do everything by yourself. Now, I ain't going to lie to your three-year-old. He should have had a regular bed like these kids over here. That bed is too damn little for that little big old three-year-old. That's the three-year-old right there. He is a big 'em. He needs a regular bed. Poor things. Well. Oh, you got you a curtain ride? Finally. Okay, well. There you have it. So Sky did a metamorphosis, too little and on the floor. Yeah, too little and on the floor. You right, sis. Hey, Trinise. I don't know, y'all. It's just a shame. I just wish, where were they sleeping before? On the mattresses, on the floor, melanated. Mm-hmm. Yeah, I know. Janae, I don't know what to say. You know, I don't know what to say. And here's the thing. Some people say, oh, leave that poor lady alone. No, she need to leave us alone. She keep uploading this stuff and we watching it. I want her to leave us alone. I want Sky to have more pride in herself. I want her to have more pride in herself. I want her to respect her home, her children. I want her to respect the internet. Because sis, if you living like that, you need to just keep that between you, those kids, and those four walls. The internet does not need to know that, okay? Now, before we get into another conversation, I want to go and piggyback off our live from last night. A lot of you guys sounded off in the comments on the commentary on Jasmine and the Hannah and the birthday debacle over there. Give me just a moment. Let me get that video, my video up, because there's a comment that I pinned, and I want you guys to read this comment. Let me make sure I got it over here. Give me a moment. All right, so let me pull up this comment so y'all can see it. Okay, so it says, when planning a birthday party for two kids involves anger, drama, territory marking, and stress on the parts of the adults, the party is not about the kids. And in this case, the two kids in question probably won't be able to remember the party in a few weeks anyway, let alone articulate anything about it without prompting. This is a waste of money and energy. Those twins need educational enrichment outside of what the school and social services can give them for free. And Aiden in particular needs ongoing behavioral enrichment and social skills. Jasmine and Phil, put your money and planning into that. Those twins probably won't lead typical independent adult lives through no fault of their own. And Phil has another child who won't ever live independently. Y'all know that's little Phil as an adult. I hope he and Fit Jazzy are being realistic about these kids' limitations and are planning for their current and future needs. 12 years from now, this drama-filled birthday debacle will not have benefited them in any way. And I pent that comment because, baby, that was a word if it ever wasn't a word, okay? I said, I know that's right, sis. Whoever wrote that was very articulate in the way they displayed their feelings. And here's the thing, you guys. I think Jasmine does things to trigger people. Someone else in my comments said that because Jasmine obsesses over people, and she does, y'all. Jasmine has a very obsessive behavior. And she obsesses over things that is so small and minute. And I believe the biggest reason why Jasmine does that, because Jasmine doesn't have anything else to obsess over. She has no life outside of the internet. The internet is her life. Her children are not even her life. I mean, Legend is, but the rest of those other four are not. And we've seen that, y'all. We're not making this up. We've seen that in plain sight. Jazz just seeks attention. That's it, Trenise. And if the internet ever goes away, Jasmine is going to be a ball of mess because she seeks attention. She seeks validation from the internet because that conversation she brought to the internet yesterday and last week, we did not need to know any of that. It's either you're going to have a party or you're not going to have a party. Invite us when the video comes up. The behind the scenes of the party, we didn't need all of that. But Jasmine is drama. That's why Chris left her, because he got tired of the drama. Now, I'm not saying Chris wasn't drama-filled himself, but Chris was used to him being drama-filled and is contained in the home he was at. Once he got food with Jasmine, he didn't realize that all his drama was going to be spilled to an entire world. Ms. Dolicia said, Jazz is autistic. My oldest son is, and he does the exact same thing. Well, I feel like if she is autistic, she definitely is high functional, okay? Because that autistic didn't stop her from moving that pelvis and get them five kids over there, okay? Suma said, Jazz has no friends or family that would like to be around her. She is inappropriate, and people keep telling her, yet she thinks it's control. She has no idea how to be a logical adult. And you would have thought throughout the years of being on the internet and all the obstacles she has conquered being on the internet, you would have thought that she would have learned some things from being on the internet. Jasmine hasn't learned a damn thing, like anything. Like, imagine going through all that you go through on the internet and you don't learn anything. Even myself, y'all, I've grown from being on the internet, interacting with other people from other different facets of life and watching what other people got going. I've learned and I've grown being on the internet. Imagine Jasmine being on this internet for over 10 years, and girl, you still don't get it. Skeely said, I totally agree with that comment. Just like Legends B-Day party. She went all out and he don't remember a damn thing. Sure doesn't. Nothing. And hell, to be quite honest with you, the highlight for us for the birthday party was Amaya digging in her nose. Hey, Miss Independent, I feel like Jazz wants to try to do like she did when Hannah threw Phillip's mom's party. She's trying to make it look like she is helping financially when she's not. No, she's not. Yeah, moving that pelvis. Moving that pelvis don't stop her alleged autism. Okay. I thought about it, Tasha. Why Phil don't want her filming because he have that charge and he don't want to get in trouble because he don't supposed to go to those places with kids. So get it. You know what Sheikah 2820 told us that last night. I don't know if you were in my live, but they basically said it. Thank you, Chinese, for welcoming Miss Independent. They basically said it, 2820 said it in our live last night, that Phillip can't be around other kids other than his own. So that's why he doesn't want to be filmed. And if that truly is the reason, why doesn't Jasmine accept that and be like, oh, okay, Phillip, I get it. It's the fact that you still want to film. I can film without putting them in it. Why just don't film, Jasmine? I don't understand what the big deal is, okay? I don't understand. But I wanted to share that comment with you because I felt like that was some real talk. Social anxiety is real. Right. How you mad at Hannah for setting boundaries on her dime? Jasmine never pays for anything solely for those kids. She always finds the cheapest way out. Hannah. Yeah, because I seen, hey, Freddie's, I seen for Easter, the grandmother got the kids the Easter basket. I said, well, damn it, Jasmine. You can't even buy Easter baskets? Like, what's wrong with sometimes saying, don't even worry about it. I got it this time. Especially with the grandmother doing everything else. Christmas, birthday, back to school, Easter, 4th of July, summertime. The grandmother does everything. And as grandmothers, that's what we do. We love on our grandchildren. However, like, damn, when you gonna be a mama? TMR, LL, but people that have major disabilities have the birds and the bees. your grandson coming for the weekend? Well, Freddie's, I hope you enjoy your time with your grandbaby, honey. If this is that issue, Phil need to be at any kid party. And yeah, that's the thing. Phillip having a situation where he can't be around kids, I mean, that ain't Jasmine's fault. That's Phillip's fault. However, that is his current situation. So if it's being said, hey, Jasmine, would you refrain from filming? Because we want to have this party without Phillip going to jail. Jasmine should be like, oh, okay, then I get it. And just leave it alone. But Jasmine's trying to make it like it's something more than that when I feel like that's just what it is. So, okay, y'all, let's get into a different conversation. So we just watched Sky's Life Clean with me, right? Well, I came across a video the other day where a woman titled her video Section 8 Income-Based Apartment. And I was like, oh, ish, baby, not another damn ish show. And I was a little reluctant to click on the video because I was like, I don't want to see another nasty Section 8 house. Although we know everybody on Section 8 is not nasty. But let me give you guys a sneak peek of this lady who decided to show her low-income housing or income-based Section 8 housing. Give me just a moment.
It is a two-bedroom, one-and-a-half-bath townhome. Now, starting at the front door, I have a gentle reminder on the door as soon as you enter to remove your shoes because we do not wear shoes in this house. I have a mat there on the floor. So that is the full entry door right there. Moving away from there, coming in, you will see a mat right there for your shoes. Then I have my TV mounts it on the wall there. As you answer, there's the TV there. Then I have a stand for my lamp right here. And this lamp, as well as a lot of the other lamps, did come from Goodwill. So it was about $5 or less for the lamp. I then have my window right there. If the lighting is so bad in here. But I have my window there. I have a stool sitting right under the window. And I did get that stool.
So let me interrupt her really quick. Thus far, you guys, it's a 2-bedroom, I believe she said 1-bath townhome. Very clean. You can tell this woman is very grateful for her income-based apartment. And she's showing it by the way she has furnished her apartment. If you guys listen to her, some of the things in the house is from the Goodwill. And again, it's nothing wrong with that, right? Because we've seen Live Life over there digging in the Goodwill to furnish her home. There's nothing wrong with that. There's nothing wrong with a little old and a little new. Or if you don't have any new and you can only do old, as long as it's neat and clean and you take advantage of your space and you respect it and you keep it clean, there's nothing wrong with that. Because as time go on, you'll be able to move out that old stuff and replace it with new things, right? But see, this woman, I believe she says she has one child, right? But this is what it looks like when you respect your space. You're a clean person and you appreciate the fact that the government gave you housing and is assisting you with paying for it. See, this is what you put on the internet. Now, the reality is there are people who are not clean. We're not going to act like everybody in the world is clean, right? And that's unfortunate, especially if you have children and you got your children living like Sky has her children living. That's so unfortunate. But I really feel like a lot of what Sky does is because that's how she was raised.
From Goodwill as well. Going over there in the corner, I have my internet connection. I also have the lamp, also from Goodwill.
Okay, so pause. I see Sheikah's mentioned Nika. Y'all know Nika, that weirdo down there in South Carolina. Yeah, I don't watch Nika. I told y'all that. I've told you guys that. I don't watch Nika like that. I don't know what she has going on. I believe she was in transition of housing. I don't know if she's found a place. I think you guys said that she was over there having her kids cuss. Do y'all expect anything better? No, really, y'all. Do y'all expect anything better from Nika? This woman has 10 kids, and she herself act like she's the same age as her oldest daughter. I don't expect anything different from Nika.
And I have a little side table, and I got my side tables that you will see down here from Home Depot. And I use my side tables to store blankets just in case we get cold and want to throw a blanket on us because this thing.
I agree with Life Below. It definitely is the ministry.
This is another view. Once you come fully in, you will see my living room set. Okay, and I'm just going to pan around a little bit. I got that picture.
Now, if y'all notice, I mean, she doesn't have modern contemporary furniture, $2,000 couch, $1,500 living room table, $3,000 Persian rug. She don't have all that. You don't need all that. You really don't. Even Sky, although she gets stuff off the side of the road, but if she would take it, clean it up, make sure it's sanitized and place it in her home. Okay, girl, you can't just drag stuff off the road and don't do anything to it. Now, I'm just going to assume the things this lady got from the Goodwill when she brought it into her home, she made sure she sanitized it and cleaned it appropriately so she can then, her and her child could then use it, right? Because somebody else used it. You know, there has been times where we all, some of us, maybe not all of us, have had to have used furniture until we could do better, right? There's nothing wrong with that. Don't ever give me, I'm not shunning anybody that have to have used furniture. Because at the end of the day, you got to crawl before you walk. But it's how, in my opinion, how Sky lives on a daily basis. So nasty and unkept. And she allows her children to live like that, which unfortunately her children are going to grow up and copy the same way they were brought up. It's kind of inevitable for them to live like that.
Picture up there on the wall from Goodwill as well. And also the pillow that you see on the floor, I use that for a floor pillow when I'm down on the floor doing things with my daughter or whenever I need to use it. Okay.
Now, this couch set and pillows were given to me.
Going around, once you start going this way, I use this as kind of like an entryway type of setup. And I have those two pictures that I got from Goodwill as well. I have another console table that I got from Home Depot that you have to actually put together yourself, like with many other places now. Okay. So I have little things on there. Now I can move back. So let me see. You all can get a better view of the list.
Oh, I'm sorry, you guys. Give me a moment. Sorry about that. Sorry about that, you guys. I clicked on the wrong keyboard. Give me just one moment. Okay, so like I said, the reality of me showing you this video is just to show you guys, obviously, as we know, everybody doesn't live like that. And one thing the young lady said in the beginning of the video, she was a little reluctant to show the world her house, more so for safety reasons, but she went on ahead and showed the people. And I think the biggest reason why she wanted to show is because obviously she's trying to grow her YouTube channel. And then two, she wanted to show people how proud she was to have her place. I don't know this woman. This is the very first time I've seen her, video. And out of curiosity, I clicked on the video, but I believe, let me say this. I'm assuming that she may have came from maybe, she might've been homeless for a little while and she was able to be blessed with this place. Again, that's my assumption because I noticed in the video, she spoke of how a lot of people gave her furniture and stuff. So maybe she had some type of hardship and she was able to be blessed with this low end compartment. So I just want to show you guys one more thing in this video.
Okay. I'm just going to pan all the way around. Okay. Now coming over here, this is a coat and shoe closet. like I have my hooded dryer here. And I have other little miscellaneous things hanging and things like that. So that's that. Now, when you come out of there, I have this. This is one of my favorite quotes. And it is, God grant me the serenity to accept the things that I cannot change. I try to keep this one pretty simple because my daughter uses this bathroom a lot when we're downstairs, so I want to make it a little
bit, furry world,
you know, just kind of not so serious for her, something she would enjoy up here. I put tea lights inside of this so she likes to have these turned on when she's in here using the bathroom and things. So that looks pretty cute when I do that. And this bar here I got for $5 from Walmart.
I'll give you guys her channel name in just a minute.
It's really meant for inside of the shower, but I decided to just use it there since I didn't have a lot of space to just things around. I didn't want to crowd the sink up and things like that. But yeah, so this is the bathroom. And the worst part about the bathroom, I have a tissue holder there too. The worst part about the bathroom is the floors, in my opinion. The floors are bad. Also back here, I have a couple of towels hanging there on a little rack.
So like I said, you guys, nothing fancy, spectacular. It's just a living space that she's created for her and her child. Nothing wrong with it. Again, it's not like she got $4,000 furniture in her house, and you don't have to have that to be clean and organized. You know, for one, you gotta want to be clean. It's not hard to do that. You just got to want to do it. And it's a process. You got to train yourself. And then obviously if you have children, you got to train your children. And I really feel like Sky started having children too early. She herself didn't really know what it was to be a woman. So then she started having children and she was kind of forced into becoming a woman. This is an assumption. I'm just going to assume the woman that raised her didn't teach her how to be a woman. Again, I'm just assuming that, right? So I just wanted to show you guys that video. The name of her channel, give me a moment, y'all. I'm so sorry. I was over here multitasking. The name of her channel is Leticia's Best. So it's spelled Laticia Best. I'll link her channel down below if you guys want to get to know her. I don't know. I didn't even look at any other videos, you guys. So I don't know how much other content she has on here. But she has a really cute, cozy space, you know. And I, like I said, you could tell she's grateful for it. You could just tell. Hey, Sean, you could just tell that she's very grateful for her space. Hey, PRB. So, one other thing I want to show you guys, give me just a moment. I saw something on Instagram, a couple things I want to share with y'all. Let me get that up real quick. Oh God, I clicked on Instagram and the first person I saw was Olivia Lord. Let me get to it. Where is it at? I thought I had it already saved on here. Oh, okay. Here it is. Now, for all of you guys that are thrill seekers and love the amusement parks, I'm just going to share a little something with y'all. TMR is not that girl, baby. I don't do the amusement parks. But I want to share this with y'all.
Oh, my God. Oh, God. Oh, my God. Oh, my God.
That was a lot going on right there, honey. That was an amusement park in Glenwood, Colorado. It's 110 foot. It's 110 foot record drop, and it drops at 102.3 degree fall drop. And in my mind, when I saw that, I was like, how do they maintenance that type of ride? Being that high in the air, like I understand someone had to, you know, an architect had to, you know, build it, but I'm just thinking to myself, how do they do safety checks on something that, baby, that was a lot going on. It that terrified me. I said, Now that, I mean, I understand roller coasters and thrill seeking, but it's so that roller coaster ride, they said it's the highest elevation mountaintop roller coaster. And it was just a lot going on for me. Someone asked if I could make it bigger. I didn't know how to make that bigger. I'm sorry, y'all. I'll figure it out the next time I show something on here. But I wanted to share that with y'all because I was just like, that's a little too much going on. Thrill seeking has taken the all-time high, huh? You said you watched that earlier in screen. Yeah, baby, that was a lot going on. When it got to the top and then that drop, woo, honey, my whole entire insides of my body would have been left right there on that ride, honey. You said I used to ride all that stuff. I think once you get to a certain age, baby, your nerves can't take stuff like that anymore. You said, don't scare me not, girl. Yeah, that was a lot going on. So let me see. It was something else I wanted to share with you guys. So give me a moment. Okay. So let me share this with y'all. And unfortunately, y'all, I don't know how to make it bigger. So we just gonna have to, you know, figure this one out. So this is Abby Hensel, one of the conjoined twins. She just got married, y'all. So I don't know if you guys know of these people. So which twin got married? The one that's closest to him or the one on the outside? Did they both agree to marry him? I'm sorry, y'all. I was a little confused behind this. I didn't understand. On the left? No, Sean, I'm serious. I'm so serious. And you said, what if you didn't want to marry? That's what I'm saying. Like, did they both marry him? Yeah, I do too, Miss TLD. It's the one on the left, PRB. Okay. So did they both want to marry him? So when one gets mad, are both of them getting mad? Okay. Legally, only one can marry him. No, you're not going to hell, truth be told. Like, y'all, I'm just like, no, I'm serious. Like, this was a serious, when I saw, I remember the conjoined twins, but that was years ago. I didn't, you know, obviously I didn't keep up with them. So when I saw this, I was just like, okay. Okay. I mean, you know, okay. I'm just going to say that. Okay. Okay. See, I'm going to stop showing y'all stuff because I can't even have a conversation with y'all. Y'all think I'm being shady and I'm being serious. I was a little bit confused. Okay. You said they both her Aries. Boy. Yeah, everybody deserves love, green heart. At this point, they're in it together. I mean, literally and figuratively. So, but they both gonna be taking that. Ugh. Oh, Lord, PRB. You said, I'm going to quickly issue a congratulations and move on. Truth be told, said, sis, it's awkward in here right now. I don't know, y'all. I saw that and I was just like, he boy. Hey, Tima, please read my comment from above. Okay, JB, let me get over here. Hey, Sun Rose. Let me see. Where your comment at, JB? Can she date? Oh, no, that was just B that said that. Oh, you asking if the other twin that didn't say I do, can she date? Sis, if one can get married, if only one can marry, then the other one is still single, right? So obviously she can date. You said, JB said, I don't know, but they share one private part and the one who got married controls it. So the one, okay, so y'all said the one who got married was the one on the left. So the one that was furthest away from him, the one that was closest to him, that's the one on the right, right? Yeah, he literally got two for one. I don't know, y'all. That was different for me. I just said, well, you know. I said, well, you know, I'm going to just be thankful, right? I got a little fupa. I'm just going to be thankful. Wow, God. Bless me to be here, okay? Because, baby, you said never in a million years, sis. So, hold on. Ghostly says, she said they both orgasm at the same time. But when they're having relations, they make the other sister read or listen to crime podcasts so she can get the pleasure out of her head. Huh. Ghostly, are you being serious? I think you are. Are you being serious, sis? Yeah, I'm gonna stop showing y'all stuff. I'm gonna just stop. I'm not gonna show y'all nothing else. Mm-mm. They pregnant? What you say, TLD? But TLD say, I'm sorry, y'all, but the way my nosiness is set up, I have questions. I know that's right. Well, y'all, you know, I'm just, there's somebody for everybody, y'all. And one thing's for sure, two things for work, for certain. They are definitely going to work it out, okay? You said you need proof. Lo said, Abby not going to be able to keep this going long. I'm not cheating. It was my sister's fault. She had a date. That's why I couldn't come home. Oh, Lord, life with Lo. I know, Sean, I'm not going to show y'all nothing else. Because, see, every time I show y'all something, it's y'all always make it my fault. Because I'm bringing it to y'all attention. And I'm like, Miss TLD, child, I got questions. So I was curious. I was like, well, wait, huh? I mean, you know, okay. So let's be honest, y'all. The reality is, why couldn't they get married? So Hold on. What happens when the other girl wants to get married? The other sister. Oh, hold on. Do he got a brother? Oh, boy. No, I'm not, Dara. He said the break room in an uproar. Sam said, sis, what's going on? No, I'm serious. Y'all act like I'm playing, and I'm being very serious. Takesha says, girl, I got 50 damn questions. Somebody just answer one. A two-man situation? Oh, boy. Well, okay. You ain't prepared us. You threw us in it and said, fight right, truth be told. PRB said, I would never F behind my sister, but I guess they had no choice. PRB, on that note, I'm gone. PRB has officially shut the whole break room down. She will be committing adultery on her Sam Dolphin. Okay, you know what? You guys are not mature. Okay? When y'all become mature, meet me back in the break room. Right, exactly, Ghostly. Whoo, y'all are a mess. That's why I love y'all. Okay? Child, I'm gone. I'm out of here. I'm going to talk to y'all in the next one. Y'all be good. Y'all be great. Y'all have a good weekend. TMI going to see you in the next one, honey. Oh, Lord. Not Usy Alert. Low. Bye, Low. Bye, y'all.